Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to show you how to change a sensor cable for L1800, 1390, 1430, 1400, all those good stuff. On the Printhead carriage, you're going to see this cable. This is the Printhead cable. So it's a fat cable and little cable. You can see how burned it is. Besides that cable, you're going to see a small cable goes into the Printhead carriage. That cable is going to read this clear belt, which is CR encoder, and also go underneath and that's since the paper width. Here I draw a small box for you. So that the innermost cable does go run all the way to your main board. The printer uses this cable to sense where the cartridge return position is. Without it, you're sending out blind people to run Olympics. So when you turn the printer on, the printer goes slam. And if you have that, you have some problem with your sensor or sensor cable. And first thing is to check the main board, see if the cable is connected. Cable, you can go to bchtechnologies.com and just search for 13P CRPW. That's a 13-pin cartridge return and a PW sensor. And you're going to see this 13-pin page width CR encoder sensor. This cable is pretty long. It's going to run the full width of the printer. First, we're going to remove this APG assembly. I'll post a video about how to do that in the link above. Now we go to the right side. On the right side, you can see this half moon thing. You want the flat side beyond the top, so you can turn it. So just keep it this way. If your printer still have a left frame support right here, remove it. And this one already got removed. I'm talking about this plate right here. Now I'm going to remove those two large torsion springs. And those springs is used to push the rod down. And then take a closer look. It got direct contact with the rod. So the whole thing is very easy to remove. Oh, by the way, this will be a pretty advanced project. You want to watch the whole thing, make sure that you're comfortable with it. And another spring on the right, and notice that half moon thing, and just keep it that way. Now when you remove it, I usually put the parts on the left at the left and put the parts on the right. I don't want to mix them up. On the right side, you got another torsion springs, and this spring is weird. It goes straight forward, and pay attention so you can just lift it up, remove it. The trick is how to install it. I'm going to show you later. And the function of this spring is to stabilize this assembly. This assembly holds the clear belt, the CR scale. And you can see without this spring, it's wobbly. Now on the left side, in the back of the printer, we're going to remove this extension spring. It's a very strong spring, so be careful. I don't want you poke your eyes out. I still need your eyes to watch my YouTube videos. Okay, now we can remove this drive belt. And we remove four screws on the top. Now we can remove this rail guard. If you wonder what this printer is, it is a DTF Pro Fusion Model J. Now down left side, we're going to move this piece, not remove this piece, move this piece. So I use a marker to mark the position. This piece adjusts the parallelism of the rod. So we're going to remove the screw and then we lift up the tab and push aside. Otherwise, this piece is going to interference with the rod. You cannot lift up the rod. And this is the CR scale. Your whole problem is your printer cannot read this scale. I think a Model J get this screw backwards. It should be from outside. Anyway, let's remove this. You can keep the scale on if you want. So just lift this up and see here and go inside and leave it there. And here you can see a white spacer and get a small plier and remove that spacer. Okay, I'm going to give you some background music of my office. Now you can hear it. This is real sound from my office. I got a couple printers working. Anyway, so use your finger to hold down that washer and use a dental tool and just scrape. And you can see the opening there. Just poke in and you expand that washer. And that washer gonna come off. Now we go to the right side and we repeat the same thing. This cable is the hardest cable to replace, I have to tell you. I haven't updated my YouTube channel quite often as before. It's because of burnout, but I get so many messages from you says my video is the thing keep your small business going. Now I'm back to YouTube. Let's get this cable replaced. So now you can see the rod if you slide to the left and so you lift it up, the whole thing. How about that? Looks scary, huh? We remove this eyeglasses thing. You can remove the bell later, but in this video I just remove first. So you lift it up from the left and then you put it down. And now it's unlocked and can be released. Now we can release the holding assembly by poking underneath and lift it up. Oh, by the way, if you need the dental tool, you can just go to my website and search for dental tool. There are also dental tools on Amazon, it's 10 bucks, but you get a whole bunch of tools that's not suitable for fixing printer. I found this specific tool that's really useful for working on the printhead. Now I'm going to remove this cover. This cover has two tabs on the top. So you poke those tabs out and then now you can, yeah, that left and right, two tabs. Now you can leave on the bottom and the whole cover can be removed. Once it's removed, you can see the sensor PCB board. Yours will be different. Yours will have a screws and going to have another cable goes to a page width sensor. The smaller cable goes to a page width sensor. But this is Model J. I use a third party board and they just loosely put it there and with some glue to hold down it. See the black glue? This is not a real Epson board. This is a third party board they made themselves. So to save a couple bucks. I said lots of bad things about Model J before, now I have to apologize. I have to say Model J is one of the manufacturers know the DTF in their heart. They know it so well, so it cut all the corners it can cut. For example, I understand you don't need a page width sensor, so they took it off. It doesn't just, don't put it there. Why do you need screws? You can just use glue. And except in this case, their crappy third-party board didn't work, so I have to open up the printer and change it. Okay, here's the BCH 13-pin cable. You're gonna take the old cable and see where you need to fold and mark it. There's only just two folds, and it's very easy. I don't need to tell you where it is. Just fold exactly the same way as the old cable. Now we replace their crap with a real Epson board with screws. Anyway, Model J is one of the best printers we used. It's really intuitive and really easy to use. I'm just saying it designed so well, we really love it. As long as you don't have to open up the printer, figure out what the problem is. If you really have to open up the printer and get a bucket because you're gonna puke. There is a saying that anybody can build a bridge that stands, but takes an engineer to build a bridge that barely stands. They really know how to give you stuff that barely works. Because I used this crap board and it removed the screws, so I have to make a screw hole myself on the carriage return. Will I buy a Model J? Absolutely, I will. Here's the thing. There are lots of manufacturers that use brand new printer genuine parts, but they're idiots. And they made mistakes making your printer not working. But this printer is different. This printer is built by somebody understand it. So have a really good bone. So I'm gonna buy it, I'm gonna change a whole bunch of parts, and it will be a fabulous printer. Okay, now is part two, the installation. So we put the real Epson board in, and our new FFC cable is nicely folded and threaded through the catch return and plugged in. Because this one doesn't have a PW sensor, so I'm just leave it empty. You don't really need that sensor. In your RIP software, you uncheck page width detection, so it will not read that sensor. Now we put a cover back. For the belt, there's one set has teeth, another side is smooth. I don't know how many times that I installed the backwards, so the teeth side should be inside the loop if you think the whole belt is a loop. If you feel the teeth, you're going to see a small section has like a bigger, thicker teeth. And that's the side that you're going to mount on the cartridge return. And the cartridge return is mounted on the lower of the loop. So the top of the belt is just a belt, and the bottom one get attached to this. And here is potentially you mount it backwards. So when you put it on, the smooth side will be inside the loop, and inside the teeth side should be inside the loop. You can just get it done and then just put it on the printer. Don't install the whole thing and make sure that the cartridge return motor is going to have good contact with the teeth. And then you will know if you install backward or not. Now we put this little pin thing in, push the loop on the right, push it down. And then you can like a latch, then you can swing the latch. Because keep the CR encoder assembly on, so we know which one is left, which way is right. If you don't know, I think left side is longer than the right side. Now we go to the left side and install the gear and the washer. Now on the left side of the CR encoder holder, and it needs to be sliding that slot. Okay, here we go. Okay, when put it in, and you need to lift the rod up and down, make sure it can lift up and down with the rod. And now you can move that the flag thingy back. On the right side, this CR motor is in the way. What you want to do is you want to slide this rod as down as much as possible. So you can see the motor is in the way. So you have to jiggle a little bit, move the rod down, and then you pull up the CR encoder holder. Once you pull it up, and you're going to see the rod is sitting on the bottom nicely, like this. Now we put a half moon thing in with the flat side towards sky. And if you have problem, put the washer in because you didn't push the rod in enough. So if you have enough space, it's really easy to install the washer. Now we turn the half moon thing is 45 degrees. And we insert the white spacers to the left side of the rod. And this is the time that didn't check your belt and previously, so you'll find out that you install your belt upside down. Anyway, so the smooth side should be outside and that the teeth side should be inside. To mount the drive belt on the left, you're going to hold your assembly like this. If you already took your assembly apart, let me show you. Here's the wheel, and you'll put the belt on it. Then slide the wheel inside the assembly. And below those two slots, you're going to see a bigger slot underneath. By bigger, longer. So we're going to put assembly in that longer slot. And we're going to push towards left, and it's going to lock. And a big spring is going to push the lever, whatever, and towards left, so it can lock itself. Now I'm going to go put the CR cables through this slot, peek it sideways, just make sure the clear belt goes through the reader that you just installed. And you can pull it through and attach the belt to the right side of the holder. We need to put this pin, or call it a torsion spring, back here. See, without it, it is wobbly. So that's the whole purpose, is to stabilize it. So we poke it in and swing to the left side and put that end to the holder. And I'll give you a better look when it's installed. Now we install the torsion spring that push the rod down. Once on the bottom, you just touch the rod, and on the top, there's a holder there. And now you lift up the rod to make sure it's installed correctly. And another big torsion spring on the left, the same idea. This is the same thing, push the rod down. Now I'm going to put the APG assembly back. I have another video about the APG assembly, how to calibrate it, so I'm not going to cover it here, and just watch my another video. Now all we need to do is tuck this cable in, and remember, this is the innermost cable that's go to this holder. The blue cable is the one we try to replace, and the green cable is the new cable. Now we need to remove this long black holder on the back of the cable that holds all the FFC cables. The key for removing any plastic from the metal for Epson is, you can see every hole has a smaller end and a larger end. Right now, you want to slide all the tabs to the larger end, but you can't because something stops you. See, you cannot slide. You just find a hole that doesn't have a small end and a large end, and you poke in, and that's the pin that holds the plate, prevent you from sliding. For example, this hole. If I push in, you can see I just slide all the tabs to the left. Okay, and same thing as installation. So if I install, I put it on the left and slide to the right, and that pin is going to fit in that rectangle hole. Now I can take the whole FFC cable bundle from the back. I'm going to mark where the old cable goes into the middle slot. And so I'm going to mark the same spot on the new cable. The FFC cable is secured by the tabs on the black holder. So you want to push and slide the whole thing down and remove from the top tab, and then you can take the whole cable out. It's pretty hard to put all the cables back to the black holder and make it holding. But just remember, the whole thing about the black thing is just holding the cables. And if you cannot figure out, duct tape. Now all the cables in, so I just put in, remember, and align all the slot to the left and slide to the right, and that rectangle pin is going to snap in. And make sure that you can touch both end of the printer, and also make sure that you don't get the cable tangled and caught on the movement. You can do a small adjustment just by pulling the cables. Now we install the top rail plate. Now the moment of truth, see if it works. How about that? I got one customer yesterday come in, pick up her repaired printer. And the moment I print a test page, when the white ink comes out, she just couldn't control herself. Her tears just coming out. Actually, for every printer I repaired, I feel the same way when it starts working. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.